This is a news flash.
Good morning. We are breaking into programming to bring you a live press conference with New South Wales authorities who are providing an update on the COVID-19 cluster on Sydney's northern beaches. Let's listen
in. Yesterday we'd advised that as at 8 p.m. last night, there'd been 15 locally acquired cases linked to the Avalon cluster. Two from the previous day had brought that total to 17. There is also one additional case of a person who travelled to Queensland that also had obtained that from that same cluster, which brings that up to 18. And then overnight, since 8 p.m, we have had 10 additional cases. So those 10 additional cases mean that in the last 48 hours, there's been a total of 28 linked to that cluster. All but one is confirmed to be linked to that cluster, and Dr. Chant will provide a detailed breakdown of what those 28 cases are and what that means moving forward. Can I please stress to everybody in and around Avalon and the Northern Beaches that for the next 3 days, you should not be leaving your home unless it's absolutely necessary. Please make sure that if you do leave your home for necessary business, that you wear a mask, especially if you're going grocery shopping, especially if you're catching public transport. And of course, stay away from non-essential activities, such as entering what we regard as those high-risk venues, whether it's a hotel, a restaurant, a cafe. People should only be undertaking on the Northern Beaches absolutely necessary activity. And if we get on top of this in the next 2 or 3 days, all of us will be able to have a much better Christmas. But if we don't get on top of it in the next few days, it could mean further restrictions down the track. We don't want to go for that. We want to see what we can manage with the existing guidelines we've set for the community. And I do want to thank deeply the community of Avalon and the more broadly the Northern Beaches, who have responded very positively to what we've asked them to do. Minister Hazzard will outline all the clinics that are available for testing. We do note that some people said yesterday they had to wait a couple of hours before they were tested. We want to avoid that. So there's at least a dozen places you can go get tested, including over the weekend, which Minister Hazzard will outline. 6 or 7 of those were popped up or stood up yesterday to give that extra ability for people to get tested as soon as they need to. Can I also express a broader message of high alert for everybody around Sydney? We know, and Dr. Chant will communicate, that a couple of the cases, although they're directly linked to the Avalon RSL or the Avalon Bolo, a couple of people at those venues weren't from the Northern Beaches. They've gone back to their home, get back to their other suburbs, and Dr. Chant will elaborate on that. But it does mean there's potential seeding outside of Avalon and outside of the Northern Beaches, and this is what we need to prevent. So everybody in Greater Sydney needs to be on high alert. If you have the mildest of symptoms, please get tested and isolate. But also, can everybody please think about their activity? Nobody should be getting on public transport without wearing a mask. Nobody in Greater Sydney should be going to a supermarket, a place of worship, or other high-risk areas without wearing a mask. It will just be crazy if people are undertaking those activities without wearing a mask, because the harder all of us work together, the better Christmas we will have, and that's certainly our objective. But even people in Greater Sydney should think about what they're doing. I know that there are a lot of Christmas parties on at this time, a lot of social gatherings. Please consider what is essential, and if you are going to continue those activities outside of the Northern Beaches, because certainly we don't want anybody on the Northern Beaches doing that, but if you are going to continue those activities, please be extra COVID safe. I also want to call out to businesses and organisations. The feedback from Health is that some venues have been outstanding in their QR codes and keeping records of who's been at those venues. Some others have been absolutely hopeless. So we need to make sure that everybody works extra hard. Nobody should be entering any venue in Greater Sydney where there isn't strict adherence to QR codes, where there isn't good record keeping, because that means you and your family are at risk. The last thing any one of us want to do is get the virus and turn up to Christmas lunch and give it to all of our loved ones. And that is a potential risk at the moment, given the number of cases we have. And we always, in New South Wales, pride ourselves on having a proportionate response to what's occurring, but I don't want to understate how serious the current outbreak is and how hard all of us need to work together to get on top of it. And that's my strongest message today. We do have the potential to get on top of it. However, it requires hard work from all of us. I was asked earlier this morning about my response to what other state leaders are doing in relation to the borders, and I'd ask everybody just to have a proportionate response to what's happening in New South Wales. If I was a leader in another state, I would certainly be making provisions about people who are coming from a hotspot, from the Avalon cluster in the Northern Beaches, but I ask people to consider the fact that vast parts of New South Wales are completely unaffected, and we want to reduce the stress as much as we can on our citizens. Many people, after months of absolute torture, for want of a better term, have been separated from loved ones, as have employers in terms of their ability to keep employees on their books. And we just ask everybody to consider that and to have a response which is measured compared to what's going on in New South Wales. But again, I want to thank the community for responding. I also want to make sure that people outside of Avalon and the Northern Beaches also are on high alert. Think about what you're doing, where you're going. Better to be cautious than not. If you're going grocery shopping, wear a mask. Jumping on public transport, wear a mask. In particular, if you're going to a place of worship, please, please wear a mask. We know where the high-risk activities are. We know what the high-risk events are, and we need people to respond accordingly. So just to recap, as at 8 p.m. last night, we had 15 community transmission cases yesterday, three other cases which brought the total to 18 from that Avalon cluster, and an additional 10 since 8 p.m. last night. But I also want to stress to the community and to everybody that as soon as health gets information about a venue or about someone who's acquired this disease who may have exposed others, you will get information in real time. You will get it at the same time I do. However, as far as the numbers are concerned, to avoid confusion, we will be providing one daily update at 11 a.m. on the numbers to make sure that everybody is clear on what's going on. So can I stress, everybody gets real-time information on venues, on close contacts, and you would have seen overnight about 15 additional venues were put on that list. Many of the people involved have been very social, but they've been largely contained to Northern Beaches. However, there are some venues and a couple of individuals that were outside that area. And again, Dr. Chant will provide that update. But please be assured you will get information as soon as I do, because that's what's allowed us to respond quickly. But just for consistency's sake, around the numbers, we'll provide a daily update at 11 a.m. until the foreseeable future. I'll now ask Dr. Chant to give her update, then Minister Hazzard will provide further detail on where people in particular can go and get tested, and also other health advice. Thank you.
Thank you, Premier.
All right, that is where we will leave the New South Wales authorities providing an update on Sydney's COVID-19 cluster on the Northern Beaches. Don't forget you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, stay up to date across all of our social media platforms. All you have to do, just search 6 News AU to find us. For now though, I'm Darby Travers. Thanks for your company. Have a good day.